This is the Prince Prints Report, where we are always engaged in the world of design printed on fabric. And welcome to our coverage of Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week from the fashion capital of the world, New York City. I'm Rodney Prince, and I'm the creative director, and I'm going to be covering this week's events from a completely textile perspective. Now, we always cover Fashion Week, but this is our first time being able to bring you video footage, so I'm really excited to be here to give you a first-hand look at some of the world's top designers and how they use prints to bring focus and dimension to their collections. And to have a little fun, we're going to ambush some of the audience members and find out what they really thought of the prints they saw on the runway today. And we're going to go backstage to talk to some of the world's top stylists and get the latest trends and scoops. So, without any further ado, let's enter the world of prints. Famous Japanese artist Akiko Ogawa, who's also a designer, is along. She's going to explain to us what the print was and the inspiration that she used in the show.
Wistful mood scenery and cherry blossom in winter night.
Okay, and was there a reason you chose the colors for the ombres that you used?
Yeah, so I express winter night, so I choose many navy and white, graduation, and some cherry blossom pink.
It was beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful collections we've seen this week. And stay tuned. Log on to Akiko Ogawa to find your pieces.
Thank you so much.
And Akai, what did you think of the print you saw on the runway today?
They were amazing. I mean, Akiko's always had a really good eye for picking prints whenever she uses them. They're extraordinary. Even the way she uses her graduation of color becomes a print, you know? The way she makes it mix. So I think it's always exciting to see what she does, and this time she didn't disappoint again.
Erin, can I ask you what the inspiration was behind the print that you used, that fabulous floral that came at the end?
Yeah, I love that print. For me, it's kind of perfect modern fairy tale print. I loved working with these magnolia blossoms in huge, huge scale. I mean, I think the scale makes it really modern. And obviously, the colors are very signature Erin, being kind of in the, you know, lavender, lilac, blush, white, but there's a very strong black line quality going through it, which I felt, you know, really connected to the print, to the other more structured graphic elements in the collection.
Awesome. People like Erin are keeping textiles alive. Thank you, Erin.
Thank you.
Did you think that the flower print that she used was a bit over the top for fall?
No, I thought it was spring. I got confused about the collection. I thought I was looking at a spring summer collection. But then in fashion, you don't have to necessarily go with what's trend. You don't have to go with prints. You don't have to go with florals. You can go bright colors for winter. You can go soft colors for fall. I mean, you can go black for spring summer.
Exactly. Just breaking the trend. Tracy, how do you feel about the prints we're seeing on the runway, like the borders and the abstracts?
I think the prints are really, really pretty. They feel so fresh for fall. You know, you don't always see something bold and light and beautiful in the colder season. And this is sort of a nice continuation from spring. I think it has a really fresh feeling to it.
Stage with Dynamic Duo, Mark and James, the team behind Bad Shavishka. I noticed, guys, there weren't any prints on the line, but you went crazy with the embellishments. Can you give me an inspiration of what the sequins were all about?
We were inspired by the nighttime sky. They were sort of like a galaxy of sequins, all with 15 different sequins on each dress, all sort of fit into a pattern.
We always do a lot of prints for our spring-summer collections, because we just find our lady likes to wear beautiful prints in that time of year. And for fall, we've really focused more on beautiful embroidery and beading.
Okay, I noticed you interpreted the burnout trend, which we're seeing all over the place. Was there something you tried to accomplish there? I noticed it looked like falling leaves, perhaps, or foliage.
It was like falling leaves, yeah. It's inspired by just the winter in Kentucky where we have our other house.
The design genius behind Cynthia Steph. What was some of the inspiration behind the prints you used this season?
The inspiration for the prints this season was all about nature. I was looking at like kind of exotic kind of like birds, like peacock feathers, and then kind of city kind of nature too. So there's a lot of kind of foliage kind of landscape prints in the collection.
Was I'm not sure if it was a burnout or if it was a lace, but it seemed like yes. A leaf print, like I see right through.
It was a foliage leaf print, which was actually a purple and black burnout satin print.
Okay, I thought that was amazing.
No, thank you.
We've been seeing a lot of fringe interpreted on the runway. What did you think about her interpretation of the fringe?
I loved, there was one dress, a little cocktail dress, that had a fringe border, and then to see it on a vest.
Right.
I love the vest. And the whole vest, it was a top, it was sleeveless. And it looked like it was something that was soft enough that you could actually touch a person wearing it. It wouldn't feel like armor.
Right.
But it also had a print on it.
Exactly.
But because it was almost made like confetti, it was subtle, so I like that about it too.
Okay, so we'll be seeing a lot of Cynthia in the editorials in Ebony, I see.
Yeah, I like the show.
I've run into super fashionable Chrisette Michelle again backstage. Okay, now what did you think of the prints we saw at Cynthia Steph this time?
Really, really cool. And I love the combination of silk and leathers. It was really, really cool to watch.
It really was. What did you think of the deco print with the feathers?
That was really cool. I mean, flappers is so in right now because, I mean, you see all the nets over the face with the flappery print looking type thing. So that was really, really cool to see too.
A lot going on the runway today in terms of prints. You got to tell me what you thought of that magazine cover print, first of all.
The magazine cover, obviously working for a magazine like Vibe, and we've had very many memorable covers. It's nice to see, obviously, an homage to magazine prints, to covers. I thought it was kind of interesting. I was looking to see if there's any black magazine group, but there was none of that.
Okay.
It was fine, but I liked the prints a lot. It was colorful, it was punchy, vibrant. Loved it.
Okay. Something that caught my attention was the typography on the jeans. And this text message generation, how do you think that'll be important? Next call?
I just think looking at the blouses and the jeans, that there was a text, it kind of, I saw the English and it kind of said peace. It was peace in all of the languages. It looked like there's Arabic and all sorts of different languages. I think obviously now is a great message to put out there with obviously all the wars happening around the world. It would be great if there was peace across the world. I think that text on clothing, it's this sort of generation is, we always get our messages in sound bites, sort of like quickly. So I think that if you're able to convey something when someone's walking by, I think it's great.
Some good observation. Thanks.
All right, then.
Prince report.